all the subscribers who are new to my channel, welcome. This is Sandhya, and all my old ones, I love you too. Thank you for watching me every week. If you're watching me for the first time, hi, hello. My name is Sandhya, and in this channel, I talk about self-care, motivation, and a lot of other crappy stuff. So welcome, sit back, grab a cup of tea. Before you jump into this video, let me tell you that I am into a lot of self-help, law of attraction, manifesting, essay type ke books. So if you don't like those kind of books, this video is not for you. Even though I've mentioned two, three fictional books which I really like and I'm excited to read also. But this video will have half of the books which are self-help motivational books. So if you're not interested, then bye. Check out my other videos though, they're fun. And yeah, let's get started. Hey guys, so today I have a different kind of video for you where I talk about all the books that I've got throughout the last 2 years and I'm yet to read, and books that you can read during quarantine. So let's get started. So the first one that I will recommend is Tuesdays with Morrie. If I have to describe this book in three words, it will be tearjerker, funny, and heartwarming. So Mitch, who's the author of this book, meets his mentor after 16 long years. Mitch is gets a job as a journalist and he's not happy about the job. His music career starts to fail. I think he was a musician. I read this a long time ago, so I don't really remember. He was a musician and he left that career because it was failing, and then he gets a job as a journalist. So he's not at all happy, and he suddenly one day sees his teacher on television, which shocks the hell out of him, and he decides to go and meet him. He finds out that his teacher is going to die, and so he decides to meet him every Tuesday and starts taking lessons from him. Lessons about how to live your life. So they meet every Tuesday, and what he learns about himself, about his life, about the value of people, mentors, is what this lovely book is about. So please give this a read. It's called Tuesdays with Morrie, and Morrie is his teacher. This is a really sweet book, guys. Ek baar padhna hai isko. I'll be honest, why I picked this up, because I wanted to start reading and mujhe sabse patli book lagi, so yeah, I know, judge me. The next book that I got is, it's called Tipping Point, and it's by Malcolm Gladwell. So I've not yet read this book, but the gist of it is that aside from viruses and diseases, ideas, businesses, colors, anything, any goddamn thing can spread like wildfire. So anything, any idea, even words can be contagious. It's not that only a disease can be contagious. And this book is about how that happens. The moment that suddenly one color is in trend and then you see it everywhere, everybody is wearing that color. So this book is about that. Tipping Point is that magic moment when ideas, trends, and social behaviors cross a threshold, tip, and spread like wildfire. So I think I'll give it a shot. I got this for 50 bucks from Leaping Windows. Leaping Windows is a cafe in Versova, in Yari Road. In case you are in Mumbai, please go there. They have the yummiest lemon cheesecake. I am excited about this book because I've read Outliers by the same, I'll put a picture over here, Outliers by the same author, and Outliers was a book which focused on the power of practice. It said that achievement is when talent meets preparation, which I truly, truly believe. And the author states that it takes 10,000 hours to be a perfectionist in something, to perfect something. So he gives various examples and he says that nobody has ever made it alone. Not a rock star, not a billionaire, not a scientist. Nobody has ever made it alone. How do people who make it to the top, why do they make it? So he gives this brilliant example of one of the most idolized rock bands of all times, the Beatles, that how they got so big. Before they came to America, they were playing at a strip club for 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, over and over for God knows how many months. So they practiced so much, it taught them how to be a great band. Before they moved to America and became huge, They already practiced together as a band for more than 1200 times. They played day after day, week after week, month after month, and they put their soul into their music. So anything that you do with dedication, consistently, you are going to master it. That is just the gist of this book, and he gives many more examples like that. So Outliers, I really loved it. It was suggested by a biker friend. Shabnam ma'am, if you're watching this video, thank you so much for suggesting this book. And yeah, so Tipping Point is by the same author. So I have a lot of expectations. Have you subscribed to my channel yet? If not, then please subscribe. It will mean the world to me. Next is the most, I think one of the most talked about authors, Murakami. And before, so this is a book that I got, Norwegian Wood. I got this from Kulaba Causeway for I think around 100 bucks. So I've read Men Without Women by the same author, and I really liked it because for a person who is not into reading that much, it was not quite a difficult read. It had a lot of short stories, obviously about men who have lost women in their lives and how it impacted them and why they chose to be without women. So it's a very interesting read, even though certain lines were full of sexist bullshit, I will be really honest with you. But still, it's a very good read, guys. So Men Without Women really kind of opened my mind, and there are certain characters that he describes so well that you might be able to relate to it and you might finally feel heard. Norwegian Wood is another book by the same author, and I'm really excited to read this. I think Murakami hit another level of popularity with this book, so much so that everybody in Japan had read this book, and it made him so uncomfortable that he flew away, like he left Japan and obviously came back. The main guy in this book falls in love with his best friend's girlfriend, and he's on a flight and he suddenly hears this song. The song's name is Norwegian Wood. And then nostalgia, 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 and that's what the book is about. Brokenness is a major theme in this book, is what I've heard. It deals with a lot of issues regarding mental illness and how broken people find each other. So sounds interesting to me. I really hope it doesn't have a lot of sexist crap like Men Without Women. But I'm really excited to read this. A lot of references in terms of music, a lot of artists are named, a lot of a lot of songs are referred to in his books. So if you're into music, particularly jazz, because I think he owned a jazz bar, I think so, I'm not very sure. Book Nazis, don't kill me, okay? So the next one on my list is How to Win Friends and Influence People. This was released in 1936. I think it's very famous for developing interpersonal skills, how to build genuine and long-lasting relationship with people. So this book is about that. So I'm really interested to read this because I can make friends like this, but to keep friends is another task. So the next two books that I have, one is The Power of Your Subconscious Mind and The Secret. Both of them were gifted to me. This one was given to me by my lovely sister, who made a special appearance in my last video, and this one was gifted to me by my ex-boss. So Shohini, thank you for gifting me this. Dono ka gist ye hai ki what you focus on grows. Never underestimate the power of your thoughts, and just by changing your thoughts, your beliefs, your vision, your life can change. Your job, your relationship with people, everything will have a dramatic impact. So Secret, I've watched the documentary, and the book I've read half of it. I find it's a little repetitive, so if you're not into reading, I suggest you go to YouTube and watch the documentary Secret ka. Power of Your Subconscious Mind, I would love to read, because jo bhi aap bachpan se sunte aaye ho na, we, aap kya matlab, all of us, whatever we've been hearing and we've been watching since we've been a kid, gets programmed into our minds, and that's what we start believing. Jaise kai logo ko lagta hai ki paisa banana bahut mushkil hai aur kai logo ko lagta hai ki paisa banana bahut aasan hai. So that is because of the thoughts and the things that we've been seeing as a kid. If you've always seen your parents saying that, you know, paise ped pe nahi ukte beta, ya ye wo, I'm struggling for money. You are raised in that side, a sort of an environment. You are raised in that sort of an environment and you start to believe that making money is really tough. Whereas some people have the mindset that making money is easy. It's not that tough. All of this is because of how our subconscious mind has been programmed and how we can change it. It is possible to change it. And this is what the book will teach you. Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This one, Think and Grow Rich, is the BAP of self-help books and it has knowledge on how to be successful from some of the brightest minds of the world, like Thomas Edison, Henry Ford. Thomas Edison, who invented bulb, Henry Ford, who was the founder of the Ford Group, Ford Motor Company. So this has a lot of advice on how to be successful, how to make money. So I'm eager to read this. Next is by my favorite YouTuber Lily Singh, How to Be a Boss. So I read this, I think 2-3 years ago, and I'll be very honest with you guys, I was very disappointed because actually I thought this is on how to make it big on YouTube, but no, it is a very generic book, how to make it in any field that you choose. So it's not actually a bad thing, but what I expected was different, so I was a little disappointed. The best part about this book is since it has a lot of philosophy and people tend to get bored, so it won't feel like a task as if you have to read this ki yaar padhna padega itna kuch seekhne ke liye, because there are very chhoto chapters with a lot of colorful images. So what I also feel is that she has put her heart and soul in this book, guys. There's one chapter, I don't remember, I read it a long time ago. There's one chapter in which she says that after she made it on YouTube, she was a star. So ek jagah she is like walking the red carpet and then the next day she has to go to an audition and then people are like, who are you? You're Lily, right? So they still don't know her. So because she's climbed the ladder of YouTube, she made it at the top, doesn't mean that if she has to switch fields, it'll be easier. Focuses on hard work, hustling, law of attraction. Give this book a read, guys. But I honestly feel this could have been way, way better, and she could have included certain things that YouTubers can also take since she's a YouTube star. So I'll still give this a 3.5. The next book that I have is again a gift, my God. How to Kill a Mockingbird, and this was again a gift from a friend. I'm yet to read this. So How to Kill a Mockingbird is one of the classics, considered one of the classics, and I think it focuses upon two major things, which is racism and the loss of innocence. That is what I've heard about this book. A lawyer's advice to his children as he defends the real mockingbird of Harper Lee's classic novel, A Black Man Charged with the Rape of a White Girl. Even though the subject is so heavy, people say that Harper Lee has written it beautifully and it is even witty. I don't know about that. Doesn't look like that, but yeah, let's see. I'm telling you, all the books that I've got are from Bengalis, man. Like Bengali friend patalo, and you'll get the best recommendation for books and movies, I feel. This is called Losing My Virginity, the autobiography of Sir Richard Branson. How I got this book is a different story altogether. Why I got this book is because I'm on Pinterest. If you guys don't know, Pinterest is an app, is a website where you see a lot of images, quotes about anything. You search any goddamn thing and you'll find images regarding that. So one day I was just searching motivational quotes and I saw there were so many quotes which were from this guy, Richard Branson, Sir Richard Branson. So I googled about him and got to know that he's the founder of Virgin Empire, Virgin Business Group, one of the greatest business geniuses of our time. It's his autobiography and how he ventured into airlines, retail, even music labels. This book is about that, his journey from being a rebellious kid to the driving force behind Virgin Group, and I'm really excited to read this. One thing that I've read about this book and heard from a lot of people is that in spite of it being around 600 pages, it doesn't feel like such a long book because it's really magnetic and gripping. And yeah, I think this is the last thing I'll read because I'm so bad at reading. I might just read and use it as a pillow and like... So when Sir Richard Branson started this business, the empire, with his friends, they thought that since they are complete virgins at business, let's just call it that. Smart. Next on my list is The Power of Positive Thinking, and it says this book could change your life. I'm game. Over 15 million copies sold. This is also one of the books that was spread through word of mouth. It's about positive thinking. So a lot of books, you guys will notice, are non-fiction, self-help, motivational books, philosophical books, because I'm into those type of books. Fiction mujhe zyada pasand nahi hai, and I'm not really a reader, so I'll try and venture in that direction also ASAP. So this one is called The Power of Positive Thinking. Okay? If you don't want to read this book, Battlefield of the Mind, I know sabko man nahi karta philosophical cheeze padhne ka. Please listen to this woman preach. Your day will be made. People who are intelligent and combine sense of humor with information, you have my respect, dude. You have my respect. Last is Autobiography of Sir Benjamin Franklin. And this is also one of the books that somebody recommended. And I got it. Because self-control to hai nahi. This is about his life. But the sad part is that it has only a few years of his life. So unki puri story nahi pata hai is book mein. I don't know. If you guys have read it, comment it below. How is it? Let me know. And if you guys want to suggest some books for somebody who is as new as me and who wants to read a lot of books, fiction, non-fiction, please comment it below, guys. I would love to learn from you. And thode tips mereko please bata do on how to read fast. I'm really trying. Meko ek do mahina lag jata hai ek book finish karne mein, because I'm a slow reader. I like to aram se read, highlight the points, take it, take notes on a notebook, really like engage in the book. But itna bhi engage nahi hona chahiye ki tum saal bhar mein bas do teen books padho, right? So please give me some tips. And have you subscribed to my channel yet? If not, then please subscribe. It will mean the world to me. Suggest me some books, comment below, share this video with a friend, and yeah, I'll see you soon. Mwah. Have an awesome day. Iske alawa also I have some books, but since I've not read 70% of them, with the spoonful of dignity that's left, I would now like to end the video and show you the rest of my books in maybe a sequel. So yeah, I'm talking extra fast today because I feel my camera is thoda sa panga de raha hai. It might get... Okay, I don't want to say it. Bye! I have a lot of stuff to read, so bye! Bye!